must be taking benefit of online teaching and doing your studies well at home. So students, in the last period we have seen the definition of living things in the lesson living things and non-living things. So today also we are going to study some characteristics of living things and non-living things. So students, the characteristics of living things are, first, living things need food. So students, can you tell me why we are eating the food? So you will definitely say that when we are hungry we are eating food. So that is not the proper answer. We need food to satisfy our hunger, that is the first reason, and second, the food gives us energy to do various activities and work, and food also required for our growth. So that is the first characteristics, that all living things need food. Second, living things move. So students, you know that living things move from one place to another place in search of food and shelter, while the non-living things do not move from one place to another. So that is the another characteristics of living things, that living things move and non-living things do not move. Third characteristics is that living things grow. Growth is a process by which a young one develops into the adult. For example, you know that plants reproduce from the seeds. The seed develops into the seedling and the seedling develops into the plants. So that is the third characteristics of living things, that living things grow. Then fourth one, living things feed. Now, living things feel. They respond to the things. They respond to the things. For example, do you have noticed the plant of touch me not plant? When we are touching to that plant, it closes its leaves. So it means that living things feel. So that is the next, that is the characteristics of living things, that living things feel. Then fifth one is living things breathe. So dear students, you will say that, ma'am, what is the meaning of breathing? So students, whenever we are taking outer air inside our lungs with the help of our nose, and the air that is present into our lungs, we are throwing it out, that is the process of breathing. So breathing means taking the outer air inside and throwing the inner air outside. So students, you must have observed that we are having nostrils, and our nostrils are cover up or contain the small tiny hairs. Whenever we are breathing in, or we breathe in, we are taking the outer air inside our lungs, and while that, the dirt or the particles that is very harmful to us, they get stuck into the hair and we get very filtered air and that is very good for our health. So in this way living things breathe. Next one is last one, living things reproduce. So what is the meaning of reproduce or reproduction? So the meaning of reproduction is giving rise to the young ones or giving birth to young ones. So you know that plants reproduce from seeds. Same, the animals are also reproduced or they give directly birth to their young ones. While some animals are like that, they lay eggs. So some animals they lay eggs and some animals they directly give birth to their young ones. For example, cat is having kitten, dog is having puppy, or the human beings are having children or child. So these are the characteristics of living things. Now again we are going to study the difference between plants and animals.
Plants take air through their tiny particles, that is known as stomata, and
animals have different different body parts to breathe in and breathe out. For example, we are having lungs. The fish are having gills. Insects are having spiracles. So like this, all these things helpful for the and plants and animals for breathing. Next one is the sense organs. Fifth one is the sense organs. Plants are sensitive, but they do not have the sense organs, visible sense organs. But we animals are having the visible sense organs. For example, we are having the sense organs like eyes, nose, tongue, like this. So this is the difference that plants are sensitive, but they are not having visible sense organs, but the animals are having the sense organs. Then next one is reproduction. Last one is the reproduction. So students, previously I told you the definition of or the meaning of reproduction. Reproduction means giving rise to their young ones. For example, we have seen that I have already told you that cat is having kitten, dog is having puppy, and human beings are having their young ones as a child. So plants reproduce from the seed. So next difference is that reproduction. As I have earlier told you that plants reproduce from seeds. Plants grow from seeds. And the animals, they give birth to their young ones. They give rise to young ones, means they give birth to their young ones. For example, cat is having kitten, dog is having puppy, and human beings are having children as their young ones. So like this, these are the main difference between plants and animals. But some among the animals, some animals are like that, they are laying eggs, and some animals are like that, they are directly giving birth to their young ones. So all these are the differences between plants and animals. So students, I hope that you have understood the definition of living things, second, characteristics of living things, and the third one is the main difference between plants and animals. I hope that up to now you have understood all these things. So I would like to stop here. So till then, you have to take care of yourself. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.